Space Solar, a UK space startup, is working on commercial-scale space-based solar power to provide clean and affordable energy from space. The system captures sunlight in space, where solar energy is abundant and uninterrupted. Positioned beyond Earth's shadow, their solar arrays collect energy 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, unaffected by weather, seasons, or time of day. The captured energy is converted into radio waves and safely beamed to Earth. A mesh network of ground-based antennas collects these waves and converts them into electricity for the grid. The beam, with an intensity 1/4 that of the midday sun, is safe for people and animals to pass through unharmed. To be cost-effective, the power satellites are large, ranging from 400 meters to 1.7 kilometers in diameter. The satellites are assembled from thousands of small, mass-produced modules. These modules are manufactured on production lines to keep costs low and are transported to orbit using reusable rockets, such as SpaceX's Starship. In space, small autonomous robots assemble the modules into fully operational satellites. Once complete, the satellites begin beaming power to Earth, while the robots move on to build the next satellite. Independent government-led studies confirm that space-based solar power, or SBSP for short, is technically viable and economically competitive with other renewables. The company estimates that space-based solar power costs are comparable to terrestrial solar power, with the significant advantage of providing constant energy day or night, regardless of weather conditions. The ground-based antenna networks have a minimal footprint, occupying only 3% of the land required by a wind farm producing equivalent power. This efficiency makes space-based solar power a practical solution for delivering clean energy without extensive land use. Energy security means dependable energy not impacted by natural disasters, extreme weather, or conflict. The system is dispatchable, which means the power output can be adjusted to complement varying power sources like wind and terrestrial solar. This means space-based solar power is a reliable, constant source of energy that helps stabilize the electricity grid. In addition, the beam point can be relocated for other needs, such as supporting green hydrogen production, water desalination, or remote operating bases after a natural disaster, for instance. Space Solar has exclusive rights to the CASSIOPeiA solar power satellite design. Let's look at that design now. CASSIOPeiA. For decades, NASA scientists and engineers have worked to design a commercially viable space-based solar power station. The challenge has been to create a satellite with an economical power-to-mass ratio capable of launching into geosynchronous orbit, collecting sunlight, and efficiently converting it into a safe microwave beam directed to a terrestrial antenna for integration into local power grids. The CASSIOPeiA concept, developed by the International Electric Company, has been adopted by Space Solar. This design overcomes a key engineering hurdle, enabling a satellite to continuously face the sun while beaming power to a fixed point on Earth. Unlike previous designs, CASSIOPeiA achieves this without moving parts, using a solid-state helix layout with solar reflectors to direct sunlight onto fixed solar panels. This approach ensures reliable 24/7 energy collection and transmission via microwave beams 365 days a year. A study confirmed that CASSIOPeiA outperforms other SBSP concepts, delivering continuous power, competitive economics, and the flexibility to operate in various orbits to serve global markets. It also verified achievable mass targets, a critical factor in reducing capital costs and ensuring an affordable, levelized cost of electricity. James Cornish, business manager at Fraser Nash, said, "It is clear from our work that Space Solar's solution is robust, and together we have been able to develop the concept even further to improve its performance and reduce key risks. We're confident in Space Solar being able to start their development program with good knowledge of the expected technical and economic performance of their products." Unquote. CASSIOPeiA's solid-state design eliminates the need for mechanical systems, which are prone to failure at the scale required for SBSP. By using fixed solar panels and reflectors, the satellite enhances reliability and longevity, ensuring consistent power delivery. Space Solar Technology. The company's satellites transmit energy using microwaves, which are high-frequency radio waves. The terms microwaves and radio waves are often used interchangeably in this context, as microwaves fall within the radio wave spectrum. Documentation shows a frequency of 5.8 GHz, which allows energy to pass through the atmosphere with minimal loss, even in clouds or rain, ensuring efficient delivery to ground stations. Each solar power satellite features a clever design with solar panels flanked by adjustable reflectors. These reflectors dynamically tilt to track the sun, directing sunlight onto the fixed solar panels. This solid-state approach eliminates moving parts, enhancing reliability. The satellites, ranging from 400 meters to 1.7 kilometers in diameter and weighing 80 to 600 tons, convert collected solar energy into microwaves for transmission to Earth. The power satellites can operate in various orbits, including medium Earth orbit, high Earth orbit, geosynchronous orbit, and highly elliptical orbits. This flexibility supports multiple applications, from powering national grids to off-grid uses like data centers, mining, and maritime operations. In geosynchronous orbit, satellites capture sunlight for over 99% of the year, only briefly entering Earth's shadow during the spring and autumn equinoxes. The satellites lock onto a secure, encrypted pilot beam from the target antenna on Earth, ensuring accurate power delivery. If the pilot beam is interrupted, the power beam instantly cuts off for safety. This proven technology, demonstrated at 30 kilowatt scale on Earth, forms the backbone of their system. Space Solar's roadmap includes scaling up power and transmission distance to meet commercial needs. On Earth, the ground station antenna, spanning between 1 to 4 kilometers in diameter, receives the microwave energy and converts it into between 50 to 600 megawatts of continuous electricity for the grid. Each rectenna, resembling a large net, covers an elliptical area of approximately 6 kilometers by 13 kilometers at UK latitudes, making it a compact solution compared to wind farms or terrestrial solar. In November 2024, Space Solar, for the first time, demonstrated a core component of the CASSIOPeiA solar power satellite, the world's first 360-degree wireless power transmission system. For solar power satellites, as they move around an orbit, they need to point at both the Sun and Earth. This typically involves a large rotating joint. Space Solar demonstrated transmission of power in all directions without the need for moving parts, ensuring a continuous power supply regardless of orientation. Challenges of space-based solar power. Space Solar faces several challenges in developing a commercial space-based solar power system. Let's look at the primary hurdles, cost, space debris and maintenance, and how the company addresses them. First of all, cost. Space Solar estimates costs in the region of $400 million for main development, and a further $400 million in capital would be needed for their first power satellite. We do also have strong interest from energy clients in remote regions for a smaller system, which would be around a quarter of the capital cost, Soltau said. Space debris. To mitigate the risk of space debris, Space Solar considers multiple orbital strategies. One approach involves assembling satellites in medium Earth orbit, just above the inner Van Allen belt, where debris risk is lower. The CASSIOPeiA design also proposes a geosynchronous Laplace plane orbit, which is less congested and potentially safer. Alternatively, highly elliptical orbits can be selected to further minimize debris exposure. Maintenance. Space Solar designs its satellites for in-orbit assembly and maintenance by autonomous robots. These robots, already under testing by various companies, will replace failed modules as needed. By including serviceability from the outset, Space Solar ensures the long-term reliability and performance of its solar power satellites. Upcoming events. By 2030, Space Solar aims to launch Merlin, its first orbiting solar power satellite. Measuring 400 meters in diameter, Merlin will operate in medium Earth orbit and beam 30 megawatts of microwave energy to Earth. At 80 tons, it will weigh one-fifth as much as the International Space Station, but cover four times its footprint. CEO Martin Soltau said, "That's essentially our minimal viable product for beaming commercial power. Like with any new tech, the economics won't be ideal, but they will be perfect for attracting contracts from governments, unquote. Soltau said everything needed to assemble Merlin in space, including robots capable of autonomously building its structures in low Earth orbit and an orbital transfer system to reach its operational position in medium Earth orbit, could fit entirely within a single Starship launch. By the mid-2030s, the startup hopes to deploy Kite, a 150-megawatt platform that's twice the size of Merlin. It would use the same modular design and operate at the maximum allowable radio frequency power density from around 8,000 kilometers above Earth. It's going to be two Starships worth, Soltau said. Looking further ahead, Space Solar plans Eagle, a 1.4-kilometer-wide satellite in geostationary orbit, capable of beaming 600 megawatts of continuous solar power. Eagle requires 8 Starship launches to build. This massive platform represents the company's long-term goal of delivering gigawatt-scale energy from space. Space-based solar power has been talked about for decades. Do you think it's now commercially viable? Will we see gigawatt solar arrays in space over the next few decades? Leave your thoughts in the comments section below. Thanks for watching. Space News Live is on Saturday evening or Sunday morning, depending where you watch from. I recap the videos I posted this week, answer questions, respond to comments and chat messages, cover any missed news, and preview upcoming content. I'd love for you to join if you can. Be sure to like and subscribe so you'll see our upcoming videos. We make videos every week covering the space industry with an emphasis on the smaller space startups that aren't covered so well on other channels. See you soon.